Hello friends, continuing with part 1, here in part 2 we will discuss how to calculate zero error, positive zero error and negative zero error. So what is zero error? Zero error in the vernier caliper is a mathematical error due to which the zero of vernier scale does not coincide with the zero of main scale. Let me show you. Here two scales are given. This scale is main scale and this sliding scale is vernier scale. And there are two jaws, these two jaws, this one and this one. When we bring these two jaws together, now you can see these two jaws are perfectly in contact. Then this zero, this is the zero of vernier scale. And this one is the zero of main scale. You can see they don't coincide. Ideally they should coincide. Means they should be in the straight line. But they are not in the straight line. They don't coincide. So this kind of error is called as zero error. So whenever we found a zero error in a vernier caliper, we need to calculate this zero error so that we can correct the final result. So there are three cases for zero error. Here is the first case when we bring the two jaws together. So now you can see zero of main scale coinciding with the zero of vernier scale. They are exactly in a straight line. So this vernier caliper is free from zero error. Or you can say there is no zero error in this vernier calipers. Second case is, let's bring these two jaws together. You see, the zero of vernier scale is ahead of main scale zero. Or you can say, zero of vernier scale is right of main scale zero. In both cases, either it is ahead of main scale zero or it is right of main scale zero. This is called as zero error and it is positive zero error. Let's calculate it. So to calculate it, first we have to find coinciding vernier scale division. So we need to figure out a vernier scale division which coincides perfectly with any main scale division. So here let's check first vernier scale division. It's not coinciding. Second, third. You can say third vernier scale division is perfectly coinciding with the main scale division. So this one, so this is 1, 2, 3 third division. So it's 3. Now to find zero error, multiply this coinciding vernier division to least count. So 3 times least count of vernier scale is 0.01 centimeter, which we found in vernier caliper part 1. So please make sure that you watch part 1. So here it is 0.03 centimeter. It's a positive error, so it will be positive. We have to put a sign before the number. If it is positive zero error, we will put a positive sign before the number. So plus 0.03 centimeter is the zero error of this vernier caliper. Let's see the third case. First we will bring the two jaws together. Here you can see zero of vernier scale is back side of main scale zero. Back side or to the left of main scale zero. So vernier scale zero is either left of main scale zero or back side of the main scale zero. In that case, zero error is the negative error. So let's calculate it. So again we had to figure out a vernier scale division which exactly coincides with any main scale division. So here let's check first vernier scale division, then second, third, fourth and then the fifth one. You can see the fifth scale division is exactly coinciding with main scale divisions. See, it's exactly in a straight line. So coinciding vernier scale division is 5. Then we will find the difference of this means total number of division on vernier scale minus coinciding division. So total number of division on vernier scale is 10 and coinciding division is 5. So we got difference is 5. Now we will multiply this number to the least count. So zero error equals difference times least count. So 5 times least count is 0.01 centimeter. So we got 0.05 centimeter. As this is negative error, so we will put the minus sign before the number. So minus 0.05 centimeter is the zero error of this vernier caliper. Please note here, when we find positive zero error, then we directly multiply coinciding vernier scale division to least count. But when we are finding negative zero error, first we will find coinciding vernier scale, then we will find the difference, and then we multiply this difference to least count. So there is a little difference between calculations, so you need to keep this in your mind. In next video, we will discuss how to read measurements with vernier caliper. So stay tuned. Don't forget to subscribe for daily updates. If you have any questions, you can ask your questions in the comment box given below. Thank you.